our coach, NCAA Regionals. I know it almost seems like it's on the schedule, but you do have to earn a trip to the NCAA Regionals. So talk about playing in the postseason.
Oh, it's just a great feeling, and I think 15 years in a row is quite an accomplishment. We're very proud of that, and we had a really nice little party at the Rarick Center the evening of finding out where we were going to go, and you know, it's the kids are always asking, where do you think we're going to go, and it's always this anticipation, and we're very pleased with Oklahoma. None of us have ever been there, so it'll be a new state we can check off our list, and the golf course is going to host the U.S. Pub Links this summer, which is nice because several of our players may qualify for that event, so it'll be a good four-day practice round for that as well. And we like the field, and we feel good about what we're doing right now. Obviously, the last day at Big Tens was very impressive from five players, and so we're looking forward to heading out to Oklahoma tomorrow.
When you first looked at the regionals, and it's kind of ironic that, okay, you end up in the Central Region this year after not winning the Big Tens, but you didn't know a lot about the course. Now, after a weekend studying the course, do you know a little bit more about it? Does it suit the team, do you think?
Yes, we know a little bit more about it, and mainly through Google Maps, which we have a man in town, Mr. Fred Mahoney, who makes us some incredible yardage books, and we're so thankful for him. And so he gives us a really good idea of what the course looks like and where we're going to hit it and where we don't want to hit it. And then just talking to some friends in Oklahoma who have had access to that golf course, that it's really straight in front of you, and there's just some fairway bunkers that we're going to need to avoid. And again, when we get there, seeing the greens and the speeds will be, you know, key to our success. And the winds, we were kind of anticipating some high winds out there, and looks like it's 15 miles per hour every day with some pretty warm temperature, so I think it'll be some good scoring conditions.
This team that you're sending out there has experience, you know, a couple of years. Even Carolina will be here for her fourth year in the regionals. How do you think that'll help this week?
Well, I think they're pretty motivated after Big Tens, and you know, to not achieve that goal, which was really sitting in the palm of our hands, that goal of finishing in the top 10 is still looming. And you know, to know that you're going to do something that no other team at Michigan State has ever done is really on all of our radar right now, and knowing that we have the ability to do that. So if the five of them play like they have been playing and like we know they can play, we're going to be just fine.
That does say something, though, on the last round of the Big Ten Championships. That first round didn't go the way you wanted to, and you had to charge back, but that really showed this team's potential.
Yes, and what we said to them after was, you know, they're crying, and they wanted to win four in a row, and trust me, so did I, but it just, you know, it wasn't in the cards, and that's just part of sports, and it's channeling that emotion into a positive light that, okay, we understand you're sad, but let's make sure that that never happens again, and how are we going to make sure of that? You know, what was the breakdown? What could we have done better? How are we going to get better? And so just talking about those things is hopefully we're going to leave the 303s behind and stay on the 289s or the 290s. So, you know, it's a learning experience, and as I've always said, which I just, you know, I listen to everything Coach Izzo says, and he said it a lot, is it's hard to win a Big Ten championship, and it's hard to win a national championship, and I'm proud that I've got the opportunity to win four, and that we have continuously been a top 20 program and all at Michigan State, and we continue to produce great players. We've got the Big Ten Player of the Year, and so I'm proud of what we're doing.
When you look around, two players are named second team All Big Ten. Caroline Powers named Big Ten Golfer of the Year. All three finished in the top five. That's hard to do right there. That's a pretty impressive accomplishment.
It's an impressive accomplishment, and it's even harder to do that and not win the tournament. And, you know, that just, it goes to show you where the breakdown was. And so we made sure that the players understood that we've got three players to finish in the top five of the tournament, and, you know, we didn't win. But it's a great accomplishment for those three. They played very well. They were tough. They were strong. And, you know, we really enjoy the Ross course. It's a great challenge. And we did have some big numbers, but made enough birdies. And so it was a lot of fun the last day.
The last two tournaments, you had six players, so have you set a lineup now for the regionals with just five?
Right, yes, we've set a lineup, so we've got Trisha in the fifth spot, our sophomore, and unfortunately Jenny, our Thai player, is headed back to Thailand today, and that's just kind of the way it goes. You know, Jenny was so steady for us all year, but we need who's playing best right now, and we really feel that Trisha has the ability to shoot some numbers under par. She did today at College Fields, We felt that we had to go with Trish.
Last question for you. When you look at the regional field, how much of an advantage is it when you look at the schedule? You play all these teams all year long, so it's not like you're like, oh, Duke's there, Oklahoma's there. You play against these teams all year.
Right, and that's been my philosophy since I got here, is to always put our players up against the best in the nation. And I'd rather go to a tournament and finish seventh or eighth than win every tournament, you know, create a schedule where we win every time or are in the top three. You know, these kids all want to play on tour, and so we've got to give them the opportunity to play against the players that are going to play on tour. And again, just as you said, it just gives us an advantage that they don't think twice about playing, seeing Duke or seeing any, you know, there's no team that's intimidating to them because they've been taught and they've been, you know, it's been ingrained in them that we are one of the best and we're just part of that, you know, that group. And so it's a comforting feeling and it's also a fun feeling.